Hi, I'm Vidya Shashank, a blogger and mommy of two. Welcome to my channel.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and today we are going to go to the next video of my session called It's All About Gram. So if you have not watched the previous videos, please go and check out the videos before hopping on to this one. Few years back, growing on Instagram was a child's play. So you just need to go open an account, post your photos and videos there, and boom, you get a lot number of followers just like that. But nowadays, due to increased number of users over the Instagram platform, it's really tough to grow. And when I say grow, it's all about being a commercialized blogger. So what is the meaning of being commercial when it comes to Instagramming? Now, some of the people who have private accounts or personal accounts and do not intend to grow or earn money through Instagram, there is no problem. They can just post their videos and photos over Instagram and they can just sit back. They don't have to worry about their reach, the engagement ratio, the way they should go and talk to brands and whatnot. But if you are planning to mint money from Instagram, if you are planning to take Instagram as a serious profile and you want to grow through that and you want to work with brands like how I'm doing right now, then definitely there are a lot of efforts which you need to put into your profile to make it grow. So in my previous video, I have told you that in order to be noticed and accepted by the brands, you need to have a really good engagement ratio. Now, what is the meaning of this word engagement ratio? Now, engagement, definitely this word itself means something which have to do with your followers engaging with you or you engaging back with your followers. So here's a formula for engagement ratio that is used by Instagram, and it is very simple. So we all know that there's a particular set standards of expected engagement ratio depending on the number of followers that you have on your Instagram. But there are always ways to improve that anytime you want, and trust me, it's the easiest thing that you can ever do. So what does Instagram basically wants from your engagement ratio? Instagram basically wants you to go and engage with your followers and your followers to engage back with you. Now, why is it important? See, let me say I'm a brand and I'm giving you a work. And if I'm giving you a work and you are an Instagrammer, an influencer who do not have a lot of engagement with your audience, that is, your audience don't come back and comment on your pictures or your posts, your videos, your stories, and if you don't engage with them, you don't reply to them, or you know, your profile, it's not a happening profile basically, then why will a brand give you work? It is as simple as that. So if I'm brand and trying to come and give a work to you, I will make sure that you have a very interactive profile wherein a lot of people come and interact on your posts. So if you are doing a product review for my brand, then definitely there should be a lot of people who are coming and talking about the product on your on the review post, and there should be a lot of people who are liking it. And naturally, when there are likes and comments, so as I told in the previous videos, there are chances that your post will get a very good reach as well. So this is how the brand looks for when they are searching for an influencer to promote their product over Instagram. First and foremost thing, as I told you, I have given a website, and I have told in the previous video also, there's a website which is being given in the description box. Please go to their website and check your Instagram engagement rate or ratio right now. It's very easy. All you need to do is you have 3 free trials per day. So you can just go and enter your username, and then you can press enter, and it analyzes for a few seconds, probably from 20 to 30 seconds depending on the speed of your network. Based on that, what you're going to do is you're going to note down that engagement rate, what you're finding at present in some notebook or something, and then try to slowly improve and make changes in your profile as to what I'm going to tell you today, and try to check your Instagram engagement rate again after, let me say, 10 days or maybe 2 weeks. And I can say definitely, if you are following all the points that I'm going to tell you over here, like wholeheartedly and you are going to make sure that you're going to work on your engagement rate, then I can assure you that it will surely, surely increase. Now, why are engagement rates important? Now, let me say you are a brand and you have got like 200 to 300 influencers who have filled your form, who have, you know, who are the potential influencers who can, you know, promote your product. So how are you going to select the best ones out of that? Because you may need hardly maybe 10, 50 or in some cases even 2 or 3. So how the brand selects the influencers is by checking their Instagram engagement rate. So what they are going to do is they are going to, it's just like any exam. So how you place them in merit order, in the same way they check the engagement ratio and then they place it in that order and they take the top 10 or top 5 or whatever are the requirement for the brand. So this is why I told you that engagement rate, working on your engagement rate, if you are planning to, you know, mint money or to make your Instagram account as a professional account and work in future, then working on your engagement ratio is like really, really important. The first one explains the word itself, which means engagement. So the first and the foremost and the most important thing would be to encourage your fellow audience, your followers, to come and engage with your content. So when I say content, it includes both stories and your posts. Stories not that important, but when it comes to post, it's the most important thing because that's how your engagement ratio is, engagement rate is all calculated upon. So that you have to actually encourage your followers to come and comment and like on your post. It can be a photo or it can be a video, but then comments are very important. So how can you gain good comments? I have already mentioned in my previous video, the first and foremost thing is to have a good Instagram community, build a good community, have a lot of people who can genuinely come and comment on your post the moment you post it, and or else have little groups of influencers who are there for, you know, give and take policy, like I'm going to comment on yours and you're going to comment back on mine. So you can form your own group, but remember, whenever you're forming any group, it have to be out of Instagram, like on Facebook or maybe on WhatsApp. And if you are doing it on Instagram, there are few rules which you have to follow, otherwise the group will be traced and blocked by Instagram. So as I told you, getting a fair amount of comments and likes on your posts are very important. And it all depends on this, because when you're calculating the engagement rate also, as I told you, it depends on the total number of likes and comments that you are getting. So other than this, there are few things which you can include in your post by using which you can definitely get or you know, encourage your followers to comment. So it can be like a CTA. So CTA is something where it's like people, you are asking a question to the people in your story. For example, you are writing about let me say World Rainforest Day, and then you are asking a question at the end like, guys, were you knowing about that, and which is your favorite thing, what is the favorite thing about rainforest, or anything which is interactive enough for the people who's reading your post to come and comment on that. Or else, let me say, if I'm you know, doing a post on a sari or any kind of attire or makeup, you can probably ask which is your favorite dress or which is a favorite kind of sari that you like, or you know, anything which involves or anything which encourages the people who are reading your post to comment on that. And trust me, even one comment matters a lot in pushing up your engagement rate. So yes, asking them to comment or making them to comment is very important. The second thing is very easy, I have told you already, is about the likes. So getting fair amount of likes, those people who are commenting will generally like, but there are so many people who will just crawl through the feed, who will just see your post, who will read it, but they will never like and they will never comment. So as I told you, if you are planning to grow your Instagram as a business, gain money through that, then definitely you need to put in a lot of efforts for that. So again, you can you know, build your whole big army who can come back and who can like and comment on your profile. Other than that, like how I told you about the pods, about the groups which you can make for commenting, similarly you can have small groups for liking as well. There are so many groups over Instagram which you can join, and you know, you can keep on liking each other's post. So something like that you have to do in order to make people like your post as well, because likes are also counted when it comes to calculating the engagement rate. A bonus to everything is definitely if there's a whole big lot of conversation that's happening on your post. So let me say you have posted about your favorite book and you're asking somebody to what is your favorite book. So they are commenting a book on that, and then you ask them back, and then they comment back, and you ask them back, they comment back. So it's like a whole big amount of conversation that's happening over a single post, and it also matters. So even small comments that you put and the replies that you get, like the same person giving two or three replies, also matters a lot, and it's add up to the Instagram engagement rate. So having a good amount of conversation instead of taking it over DM, please encourage your followers to ask each and every doubt on the post. Now we can't be very harsh with them, because even when I post, if all the people who ask me doubts regarding the post which I put on my DM, instead of asking me in the DM, if they would have asked on my post itself as a comment, my number of comments would have definitely touched 400 or 500, but then that never happens. So a whole lot of conversation happens on the DM, but that is never taken to comments. So it's like you can request your followers when you are in the growing phase, you can definitely request your followers to ask doubts or queries or whatever they have regarding that particular thing on your post, instead of asking the doubts, going to your DM and asking the doubts over there. So yeah, so that's how you can definitely encourage them to have a whole big lot of conversation in the comment section itself. That's all for now, guys. So I have already discussed a few topics over here through which you can increase or boost up your engagement rate. So we are just going to quickly revise everything again. So the first will be naturally to make sure that you encourage your followers to comment on yours. Then you can form pods or groups wherein people actually comment to you, and same applies with likes also. And third, I told you about having a CTA or a question kind of post wherein people actually they are tempted to come and answer or type something in the comment section. And the last thing for sure, as I told you, to encourage any kind of conversation that happens on the DM instead of happening over the DM, happening it directly on your post itself. So just ask your followers to do that. So these are just a tip of iceberg, which there are so many things which I have to discuss, but then these are the few starting tips I would like to give when it comes to boosting up your engagement rate. So stay tuned for my next video, that is part 2 of improving or boosting up your engagement rate over Instagram, and I'm going to discuss some more important and easy to do methods using which you can increase your engagement rate. So as I told you, after watching this video, please go and check and note down your engagement rate right now. Work upon these things and check your engagement rate again after a period of 10 to 14 days. And I can assure you that there will be a huge difference. And why do you think I'm telling you this one? Because I have experienced it for myself. My engagement rate was very less. And after I started, researching and bringing about those changes in my Instagram profile, trust me, after 2 to 3 days itself, when I checked again, because I was so sad, my engagement rate was so low. But then, there were people who were telling me it's okay, because when you have a lot of followers over Instagram, then definitely your engagement rate will also be less. But then I wanted to work upon that, and I researched and I applied all the points that I have been discussing over here, and within 3 to 5 days itself, there was a fair number of increase in my engagement rate. So after 10 days, definitely, if you are going to follow all these steps, though, there'll be a huge difference between your engagement rate. Now, And when you apply, naturally, it becomes, you know, like a habit, and then everything just goes off smoothly. So as I told you, stay tuned for my next video when I'll be telling you more tips to increase your engagement rate and to build a very good, image in front of the brands that are approaching you. So till my next video, stay tuned, stay positive, stay creating, be happy with lots of love. It's Vidya. Bye.